then pay attention. I don't want to see you talking all the time. You know, why did you come? Why'd you come? Just go sit somewhere else. Because you're pissing me off. This one is actually, we actually thought before the last little tour in the summer, we thought of doing some numbers that we'd never been done before. We'd never played them live. So this is one of them that Rob and I, good evening, how are you? You're late. Don't mess with me. You want to hear the music? Fine. All right. So this is the opening cut to the album called Frampton's Camel, which is actually available now on brand new 800,000 milligram vinyl. And it's in the lobby, I think. And you can pick it. If you've lost your copy or only have the cassette, now's the time. This one's called I Got My Eyes on You. Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. So I have a little thing I wanted to tell you right here is that recently, to my surprise, someone called me up and said that I've been nominated for the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. And so I looked and I said, by Jove, I am. And it sort of blew me away, and as I think it would anybody, especially if they're not a musician. what I found out now is that, you know, my kids know this, all my friends know this, and people that work for me, you can vote every day. For me, of course. None of that Ozzy Osbourne. No, I love Ozzy. You know what Ozzy is? He's the rock and roll Betty White. He really is. He's lovable, isn't he? Especially when he's eating those bats. Anyway. No, I like him. He's a nice man. A little crazy. Aren't we all? So, yes. So this is the plan, ladies and gentlemen. I know you're feeling a feeling of dread coming here, I know. But what I would like you to do is, normally, I'm not a big fan of, you know, the iPhones with the light on going, hey, Pete, hey. So, but now, today, for this day and one day only, in Hanover, that's what they told me to say. Where the fuck are we then? I thought we were near Baltimore. But they always put this, you know, the, I've even got like the, down here, I've got the zip code of where we are. That does you no good, does it? So, not yet. So anyway, get out your phones, okay? Have you got them out? Of course you do. Okay, now on the screen here, if you zoom, I've zoomed in from the back of the hall on that QR code and it works. So please zoom in. And you can vote, and I will really thank you so much. I've got to get to that second position again over Foreigner. And we will wait. This one we're going to do now. One of my all-time favorite artists did the definitive version of this, and we've copied his arrangement, and it's an old song, but it's a melody that to die for. It's a wonderful melody, and we'd like to pay tribute to the great Ray Charles. Thank you. right in. So here we have a situation. Hello, sir. What is over there? Okay. So this number we're going to do now is probably one that escaped you. It's on the Frampton record, which is the one before the live thing. It's on the Frampton album, the one before the live thing. I knew we should have had an opening band, warm them up a little bit. Anyway, yes, seeing as you probably don't know it, I wanted to tell you, by the way, did the crew, as you came in, were the crew playing you the audience reaction from yesterday? Did they play that? Oh, well, this makes no sense then. Well, no, we'll just go ahead with it. So basically, we record multi-track every night, the band, so that the following day we can go listen to it and the file, not the tape anymore, it's the file. And I just do my files. And see, you know, oh, I'll never do that again, or, oh, that's not bad. But the byproduct of that is, seeing as we have now, when I started recording in the old days, we had the one or two tracks, I mean, but now we have like 80,000 tracks. So every instrument, every string is on a different, right? Your strings?
Yes. Each key.
Each key is on a separate track. And Dan's cymbals and stuff, everything. Well, yeah, you always get more tracks. And so anyway, the byproduct of that, of course, is that we get to record every one of you. So we have so many tracks that under each person's seat, even those that didn't turn up, we have a microphone. So those in, you know, row P or whatever it is, I think it's seat 18, something. Be careful of what you say, because there's a very expensive mic under your seat. It picks up everything. So look, at the end of this song, just so that we can compete with the next audience, and we want to vote you as the best audience of the tour, obviously. Save it. You're going to need the energy.
Okay.
So at the end of the song, I'd like you to just go batshit crazy and just, you know, let's hear a little bit of it now. Yeah. That's it. Okay. Don't waste that. Don't waste. That's exactly what we're talking about. And this is whether you like the song or you don't. Right? It's a deal, right? It's a deal, right? Okay. All right. So I'm not gonna say anything. I'm just gonna like maybe roll my eyes at the end of the song or something. Oh, sorry, and my eyebrows. And you'll go batshit crazy. So this one's called. You love this one. It's called The Crying Clown. Thank you. waste of time. You're sipping gin and lime. You had to walk away. It haunts you every day.
Thank you.
We've played that one a couple of times now. Mott the Hoople, did you say? I love that band. Have to have a little bit of tea. So, I don't say anything here. No, I don't speak here, so don't listen to me. All right, I'll say something then. I'm not going to speak. Well, maybe I'll say something. No.
Thank you.
am in complete control. Was just priceless. Where are you? Oh, there you are. Okay. There you are, madam. Yeah, give her a round of applause. She loves me.
It's my birthday today!
I am between relationships, so... could go on, but I'm not going to. Okay. What's this? Oh, I know what this is. Sometimes they have to tell me, Peter, the next number is. It's like, you know, the guys in the control room for the newscasters. Otherwise, they'd be like this. Let's not hang about, man.
Thank you.
Forget this, they said. Got it.
Here we go.
Got it now. Thank you.
First time's a charm.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah.
Thank you.
both love. This is the best band I've ever been in. The caliber of player up here is incredible. I'm so lucky to have these people. They hate me, but they play for me. Just the money, you know. Now, we're like a family, and it's been like that for many years, and so we always look forward to getting together. But I have to say right now, this is a superb. Everyone up here is a superb musician. And yeah! Woo! So, the next superb musician is Allison Presswood on the bass. The only thing is, she stole my hair. That's the only thing. And of course, the mighty drums. The mighty drums of my favorite drummer, Mr. Dan Wojciechowski. And fresh to this tour is now his fifth show. Five shows, we welcome Pat Bergeson. Unbelievable, right? Do you feel like we do?
Yeah. Normally, well, not normally now, but before I was became non-upstanding and sitting down here, we normally, after Do You Feel, we would rush off, go backstage. The tour manager would have lots of drugs for us ready. Can't do that now. The old ticker would give out. Anyway, but so, and it takes me half an hour to get on and off my show. What are you gonna do? So what I thought we would do here is just, it's so nice to sit here for a minute while we listen to your wonderful applause.
Humble pie.
I just want to say that I never thought I'd be able to be out here playing this long. And
there's
this damn disease on my muscles. But we're not giving up on this. I'm going to fight this. And you give me the energy to get up here. You know that, right? A little adrenaline and a lot of love from you, and I can play.
It's
funny because, you know, my legs aren't doing so well, obviously. And but every time I sit down and I pick up a guitar, my fingers still work. Thank you all so much. Never, ever, 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 ever say never.
I saw
what they about. Good for you.